Revelation time. Revelation time is now. Revelation time. 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 Revelation time. Revelation time is now. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I wish to introduce to you a very spectacular program. Amen. Jesus is always known to bring spectacular program at any point in time, especially this kind of program, Revelation Time. The title we are looking at this time around is Overcoming the Dragon, and we shall be looking at Revelation chapter 12 from verse 1 to 17. So we are taking the opportunity to introduce this year's Revelation Time to you, and we want to tell you that the dragon shall be subdued under your feet. So this program is all about mine, my life, and your life, so that we can actually get opening of eyes on the things of the kingdom. Now, what is it all about? It's about Jesus, of course. But now, Reach the World Mission, which I represent, present this very important, timely end time ministration to all the world. But this time around, we are meeting in this one, we are meeting on 14th of August 2016, this year. August 14, 2016. And the time for this one is 2:30 here in the United States. And the venue is 8629 Liberty Road, Suite D, Randerstown, MD 2113, and is CAC Ayobabalola Center. That's where we are using, and the time is 2:30. Please be prompt. Come with your family, come with everyone. But meanwhile, who is behind this? Jesus. The Lord is behind it. The Holy Spirit is in charge. But He has actually given a mandate to us in Reach the World Mission to actually publicize even some of the mysteries of this end time. And that is why we bring Revelation Time to you. Now, I want you to actually think about it. What is ill about this revelation? Remember, Jesus Christ revealed this mystery of revelation to John the Baptist. Let's look at Revelation chapter 1. Are you there? Open your Bible if you have opportunity, because even though this is a publicity, but we can use opportunity for us to understand certain things that we are looking at. Don't forget, 14th of August, 2:30. In 8629 Liberty Road, Randerstown, Maryland, United States of America. By 2:30 on that day, we'll be ready and waiting for you. And oh no, the Holy Spirit is waiting for you. So open your Bible to see what is all about the revelation. I said God gave it to Jesus to give to his servant. Look at Revelation chapter 1, verse 1. Revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him to show unto his servant things which must shortly come to pass, and he sent and signified by his angel unto his servant John. Amen. Who bear record of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus and all things that he saw. Listen, verse 3 is very important, because coming to Jesus, knowing Jesus, and actually getting revelations need some things. Look at the principles that is given in verse 3, Revelation 1:3. He said, blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the word of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand. The most important thing, God loves readers of his word. And they not only the hearer of his word, but more importantly, the keeper. If you love me, you will keep my commandment. So we are invited to this program not just to come and hear, not to go read your Bible, not to read all the flyers, not to just take it, but to meditate on the word of life that can make you to overcome the dragon. Anyone that does not overcome the dragon cannot see Jesus. Because there is an obstacle placed by the dragon, by the devil, right from the beginning, that nobody will be able to make it to heaven if he is still existing. But remember, we overcome him. Hallelujah. Let's quickly look, before we go into the overcoming in the book of Revelation chapter 12, I want us to see that these important passages are very important. From Revelation 1 to the end 22, even from Genesis, there have been revelation. All the things there are revelation, and there are things that are mysteries to man. That's why some people say God didn't create the world. How did he create the world? Where is he? Because everything about God is mystery. It is something that needs to be unfolded, and those who do not have eyes cannot see. Because you think you see, the Bible says, but you are blind. Let God, Jesus, anoint your eyes with eyes saved, so that you can see clearly. Something we think they are rich, but they are poor. Buy of me gold. There is gold, resources, treasure in the word of life that we are reading. That's why I want to give you opportunity that read the word mission. We give you some instances, what you've never known before, and you'll be able to understand. Remember, in the book of Revelation, let me just do a little summary of the book of Revelation. Just a little summary for today. From that one that we are reading, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, the Lord was talking about the churches from Ephesus. He spoke to them, and eventually he spoke about Laodiceans. Some of the work in them, the one he loved, the one he condemned, the one he told them to improve upon, and some of them that if he knock the door and they do not open, they will not be able to make heaven. To overcome the dragon, number one, the door of your heart must be open. And when it's open, Jesus come in and he abide there. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus is residing in me, and that is the victory I have. And I want you to come and obtain, to come and take part of it and taste it on the 14th of August 2016. And I've told you, we are waiting for you. Before I continue, I want to sing that song for you again. Revelation time. Revelation time. Revelation time. Is now. Sing with me. Revelation time. Revelation time. Revelation time is now. Hallelujah. Revelation time. Revelation time. Revelation time is now. Hallelujah. So now I want to do a brief summary of the book of Revelation. I will do it quickly. I'll be able to finish. But come on that day, you will even receive certain things that you can look at and see what it's all about. Revelation in chapter 4, we're taken up. And immediately around that time, we saw the seventh book sealed with seven seals. That's only Jesus that can open. Hallelujah. The owner of the world is the word that can open the world. Listen, the owner of the scripture, of the scroll, is the only one qualified to open it. Nobody else. And that's why you need the Holy Spirit. In the interpretation of the word of God, you need the author of life. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. With him was all things made. There was nothing made that was made. In him is life. The life is the light that shineth in darkness, and the darkness that could not comprehend it. He came of his own did not receive it. As many as received it, he gave them power to be a child of God. Amen. So they that are not born of the will of man, of flesh, nor blood, but are born of the Spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. And that's why when you say you are born again, the Bible says, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but incorruptible by the word of God. First Peter chapter 1, and look at it in verse 23. And you can even look at the first one I was saying, 1 John 1, start reading. And if you seek the book of 1 John 2, John 1, then 1 John 1, you see how John, who the man that God is using to reveal the revelation to us, how he bear record the witness. He said, this is things we have witnessed, we have tasted, we are within. It's a practical thing. Come to Jesus, you will know that Jesus and the Lord is practical. Revelation to you while you are sleeping, while you are waking, while you are going, while you are walking, while you are eating. Revelation time is now. So now, in chapter, and he continued to unfold until the seventh sea was open. Then another thing started to happen. The seven trumpeters came out, and the seven trumpeters, they started to trumpeting until the last trumpeting. That, and amongst this one, the Bible says, mention three woe. Woe, woe, woe. One woe pass, second woe pass, third woe pass. Then you will see that before, at the end of the seventh trumpet, then we saw eventually in the book of Revelation that God actually, angels were given that have the veils, the wrath of God that is going to pour upon the nations. The nation through now, they do whatever they like, they do even whatever they like, they talk any nonsense, but there's a time that God is going to pour his wrath upon the world. And that is where Jesus is coming to rule with the rod of iron. Jesus, the Lord, is saying, I am my Father, I one. There are three that bear record in heaven: the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. So three are, I said, these three, they are one. Father, Son, and he said, I am my Father, we are one. And I'm going and send to you the helper, the comforter. And that's the one with us. That's why we are able to see with the eyes of the Holy Spirit, and we are able to hold, understand revelation. So, and as the grid unfold, we are now looking at a parenthesis in chapter 12. Parenthesis, a kind of a brackets, because there are so many brackets. If you look at chapter 10, chapter 11, this chapter 12, you can see there that is a little bracket too here, and it's talking to us about the woman. So I'm going to briefly look at that chapter 12 before we go and pray. But I'm still inviting you to come and taste of the Lord that is good. Actually, this program will be happening here in the United States in Maryland. And as it's happening here in Abuja, in Nigeria, it is happening us also. And then actually you can actually, in Lagos, you can meet a pastor there, Pastor Valua Bayela. Then you can go to Abuja, you meet a brother, Brashegun, in that place, Brashegun Bamidele. If you get to Olorun, you can meet Brashegun, Obasanjo there, and he's waiting for you. These brethren are waiting for you. Here in USA, we are waiting. My name is Stephen Lakitan Alabi. I represent Read the World, and all these members, some of our members in the ministry, they are coming. One day we'll be able to come together to tell you about what we believe. So in chapter 12, I have short time to go, so I need to just tell you that we are overcomers. Say that I'm more than conqueror. Overcomers in chapter, right from Revelation chapter 12, let's see verse 11. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, that they loved not their lives unto death. Blood of Jesus that speaketh better than that of Abel is the overcoming weapon. Come to come and overcome devil. Jesus is waiting for you. God bless you. Can I pray with you before you go? Oh, close your eyes. Be ready, open-hearted. If you have not given your life to Jesus, this opportunity to receive Jesus Christ. Jesus is sweet. Jesus take us to the kingdom. He's ready. He said, I'm coming with my reward is with me to give unto every man according to how his work shall be. Jesus is waiting. Come, please bow down your ear. Confess your sin. Accept Jesus Christ, and he's ready to save you. Father, we thank you for as many people that have he had you that are ready for Christ, ready for a change, ready for heaven. Please help all of us so that we will not miss the rapture. And in this time that you are revealing it to us, we love Father, listen and be attentive, and your will shall be done. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you in Jesus' name. Revelation time.